Good morning, my dear students. Today we will learn Unit 1 poem Life, written by the poet Henry Van Dyke. This is a memory poem and it is a very good motivation poem. The poet says that we should enjoy life whatever it comes, because the life gives you the ability to love and work and play and watch the stars. Let us see about this poet Henry Van Dyke. He is an American author, poet, educator and a clergyman. Clergyman means the person who offers prayer in the church. Here we call fathers and brothers in the church. You must be knowing them. This poet has served as a professor of English literature at the Princeton University, which is a very famous university in America, between the period from 1899 and 1923. He was also a lecturer to the American Academy of Arts and Letters, and he has been honored by many awards. So this is the background of the poet Henry Van Dyke, who is an American poet. Let us get into the poem, The Life. The Life is a sonnet poem which is of 14 lines. First 8 lines is called as octave. Second paragraph six lines is called a sestet. So octave means generally 8. It's a simple, small lyric. That is why the 14 line poems in the English literature is called as sonnet. Let us see the first paragraph of Life. In this poem, let me read the paragraph, children. Please listen. Let me but live my life from year to year, with forward face and unreluctant soul, not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear. In the dim past, now holding back in fear from what the future wills, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. See, in this poem, the poet is saying that he would like to live a life. He is also advising us that live a life from year to year, means from a moment to moment, from every instance, from every second, we should live the life to the fullest. With forward face means with a hopeful face, with an optimistic idea, with a happy idea that I will have a good life. Like that, with forward face and unreluctant soul. Unreluctant. Reluctant means not showing any interest. But unreluctant means to show the willingness that I will win in my life. So the soul of the poet wants to face a life with a forward, with a happy mood. The next line says, not hurrying to, nor turning from the goal. The poet is saying, when you are fixing a goal, you should not hurry towards it. When you are hurrying, then everything will be spoiled. Not mourning for the things that disappear. Not mourning means you should not feel that this is wrong and I feel very bad about thing. If something that happens in the past, for that we should not feel sad. Let the past live and we see the future. So in the dim past, that means not mourning for the things that disappear in the dim past, nor holding back in fear from what the future wills. So the poet is saying that we should have a we should face life with balance, with a balanced mind, and we should not worry for the things that has happened in the past, and we should not feel fear Fear means what will happen, like that worrying about something that may happen in the future in the negative manner. So we should not think for the future also, which is hidden. Wheels means which is hidden. So we don't know what will happen in the future, but we should have the courage to face whatever that comes in the future. That is what the poet is saying here. But how he is saying, see, but with a whole heart and a happy heart, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. Whatever comes in my life, whatever that the past has happened, I will live in the present only. With wholeheartedly, I make myself happy. That pays its toll means, the pays its tolls means we are enjoying the life with the happiness, not mourning for the things that has gone in the past and not also feeling for the future. We should work properly in the present so that the future definitely will be bright, both in the young age and also in the old age. That is what the poet is saying, that we should travel the life with cheer, means with happiness, with delightment, with excitement. And everything will be okay, with confidence. Like this the poet is saying here. Next, let us see the six lines sestet. So let the way wind up the hill or down, over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. So the poet is saying, let the way, that means the life, the every moment of the life, the path of the life may be ups and downs. So here the poet is saying, comparing hills and down, the plateaus, the plains. Hills means maybe we are in the better way, in a rich manner, in a happy manner. Down means we may suffer from any financial crisis or any relationship crisis or any crisis, but we should have, maybe the life is very rough or it may go very smoothly, very happily, but we should keep ourselves joyfully, with confidence we should face the life. That is what the poet is saying here. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. Seeking means what? We should search. We should explore our life. What is I have given birth to in this life, I have to enjoy to the. Like a boy, the poet is saying that we should have excitement, and also as a matured person, we should have search in our life. New friendship, high adventure, and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest and hope the road's last turn will be the best. Here the poet is saying, when he is moving towards his life, he will be having a lot of new friends and lot of adventures. The adventures teach us a lot of lessons, and because of that, one will be honored, one will be respected, one will be reaching the crown. And he is expecting, and hope means expectation, the roads, that means the lines, last turn, that means the last moment will be the best. So here the poet is explaining in a very fantastic manner, that we should have confidence in our life and we should face the life with courage and should have hope in our life. See children, in this poem the rhyming scheme is, you can see here, you should see the last words of every line. So here disappear is a rhyming word, soul, goal is a rhyming word. So the first four lines has, yeah, here is A, disappear is A, soul is B, goal is B. So the rhyming scheme is A, B, B, A. The rhyming scheme is A, B, B, A. So like this, next line you can see, fear, hold, told, cheer. So fear and cheer are rhyming words, hold, told are rhyming words. Same rhyming scheme children, it is A, B, B, A. In the same way, in the sestet also, down, crown, rhyming words, joy, boy, rhyming words. So again it is A, B, B, A. Quest, best, you can put C, C. Generally, four lines comes and the question is asked. Please prepare for that. You know alliteration words. You can see the poetic devices also. Now, let us see the glossary of this poem. Already I have explained, mourning means feeling on expressing great sadness. Mourning means expressing or feeling sadness. Veils, to hide or cover something so that cannot see clearly or understand it. Crown, a prize or honor or a position offered for being the best. Quest means a long search for something that is difficult to find. Unreluctant, willing to do something. This form is generally not used, but the poet has coined it for emphasis, importance. Here again, the meaning of sonnet is explained. It is in the book bag children. Generally, book bag questions are asked in one mark question. So please thorough it so that you make a notes of these things. Now let us see some text questions. In the first two lines, let me but live my life from year to year with forward face and unreluctant soul. What does the word me refers here? The word me refers to the poet. What kind of life does the poet wants to lead? The poet wants to lead a life with forward face and unreluctant soul. Not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear. Why do you think that the poet is not in a hurry? The poet does not want to hurry or turn away from his goal. So he is not in a hurry. What should one not mourn for? One should not mourn for things that disappear. Let us see the last paragraph. In the dim past, no holding back in fear from what the future wields, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. What does the poet mean by the phrase in the dim past? The dim past means unhappy past experiences. Is a poet afraid of future? No, the poet is not afraid of future. How can one travel on with cheer? One can travel on with cheer by thinking of the experiences of the youth and old age. This is what the book bag questions for which I have given very simple answers. Children, please take note of all these questions and answers and revise yourself for a simple evaluation and memorize the poem, which is very, it is important to memorize it. Thank you for listening this very meaningful poem, children. Thank you all. Please send your assignment to my mobile number. You know it very well. Thank you very much.